Hi, welcome today to this edition of the Chamber program where we're going to be talking to Tim Collins, who is a past chairman of the Lubbock Chamber of Commerce, and he's the current chairman of the Lubbock Entertainment Performing Arts Association.
Good job, Eddie.
So I'm glad I was able to spit that out. LEPA, as we affectionately call it. But what we want to do today on this particular session is to be able to make sure that all of you are aware of what the current status of Buddy Holly Hall for the Performing Arts and Sciences. One of the things that I think are one of the most exciting things that are going on in Lubbock in my history here in my short time in town. And Tim and I had an opportunity to actually start this effort with the feasibility study about 5 years ago, maybe 6 years ago.
2012.
6 years ago. So this is a great opportunity. I really appreciate both Tim's leadership, but also more than that, his service to the community. So today, and give us an idea of where you are in the progress of Buddy Holly Hall, and as far as its construction, and then give us a little bit of expectation of what we can expect of both what and when it's opened.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, you can drive down Marshall Sharp and see where we are in the construction process. This is an amazing construction site. Steel erection began just a week or so ago, and they're putting the steel beams together. They're going to be setting a massive truss here at the end of the month. It's just gigantic. It's the web is 12 foot tall. It's 150 foot long. The construction process is going really great. The winds of the spring always cause us a little bit of slowdown, but we're working our way through that. And so the construction piece is going very, very well. We expect that our opening remains the first quarter of 2020.
And that's not that far away.
It is not very far away, absolutely. So that piece of it is going very well. We're excited about what's happening. We're working with, continue to work in our fundraising, but we have interim financing in place. I had someone ask me the other day, what happens when you run out of money? Well, we have a finance package that was put together by 9 local banks, and so they are going to be stepping in to help us as we continue with our fundraising. Our fundraising totals a little over $100 million, but we need to raise $155. There's ample opportunity for folks who want to buy a PSL or a PIC or to support the project, but things are moving along very nicely, just as we had planned.
Well, and it's great because obviously as those of us who drive by it every single day, even sometimes on the weekends, have had a chance to see that progress, and it's great to see that in not only a cornerstone but an anchor in downtown redevelopment. So we're very fortunate that the location worked out to where it is, and so we're very happy. And being in the arts district, the arts and cultural district, you know, it's a great tie-in to that part of the community as well. So give us a little statistics then, or a little bit of facts about what the size and scope and everything of the hall.
Yeah, it's 220,000 square feet is the size of the building. The main hall has 2,200 seats over a first floor and 3 balconies. There's also a 425-seat theater that we have designed specifically for smaller productions and to be used by the Lubbock Independent School District. The facility also has about 22,000 square feet dedicated to Ballet Lubbock. We'll have a bistro, which will be managed and operated by United Supermarkets and Market Street, which we're really excited about.
Great partnership.
Absolutely, great partnership. In the basement, there is a full catering kitchen, and so we will have food service. We'll be able to host conventions. We'll be able to host luncheons and dinners, wedding receptions, all manner of things that'll happen in the building. You mentioned downtown redevelopment, and so many pieces came together to make that work for this project to be built downtown. And you know, I say often that this building is going to be incredible. It's going to be a show place, but the building itself is not downtown redevelopment. It's the traffic. It's the folks that'll be coming in to see productions, the parents and grandparents that'll be coming to see their children participate in LISD events. The Ballet Lubbock parents and students will be coming down 4 nights a week. And then the bistro 7 days a week. The traffic, the people that now have a reason to come back downtown, that's downtown revitalization.
That's going to be huge. That'll help not only that day-to-day business needs in town, but it'll also continue to attract new businesses and new operations as well downtown. So it's going to be a huge deal. So you talked about a lot of the events, not only with the LISD and the Ballet Lubbock folks, but there's going to be a lot of other opportunities to do quite a combination of different events in the Buddy Holly Hall.
You're right, Eddie. The facility was designed to be very, very versatile. And so obviously we have our local symphony, we've got our ballet company. But we will also have touring Broadway. SMG is a nationwide company that manages facilities like this, and they have been hired by us to manage the building. And so they'll be responsible for booking all the variety of talent that would come in and use the building. And that's touring Broadway productions, that's comedians, that's musicians, it's all kinds of acts. And we've seen what has happened at the Wagner Noel in Midland. And all of the activities there. Well, SMG manages that facility too. And so we're just going to be another stop, or maybe the primary stop, for those touring productions as they come across the country. And so I think we were going to have all kinds of different use there. The building is sized appropriately to be an NC-15. And of course, I didn't know what that meant, but that's noise criteria. Level 15, and that's the same as the Lincoln Center in New York City, the same as Bass Hall in Fort Worth. So it's state of the art, and it's designed for what the new touring productions want. Three dock doors was a big deal, and we've talked about this before, but Lion King will not come to a venue that doesn't have three dock doors. Yeah. All of the necessary parts and pieces in the backstage to house shows like Lion King, Phantom, Les Mis, and all of the new ones that are coming out. So we will have our choice of all sorts of major production, direct from Broadway, direct from California. It's going to be really exciting, and of course I feel like we're going to have a honeymoon period. First 4 or 5 years, we're going to have a lot of activity, yeah. And we're going to have a lot of people in the building, but we're still geared for the local community. And I emphasize that because Ballet Lubbock and the Lubbock Symphony Orchestra are an important part of our programming. The local dance companies who may have a recital, they're going to have a choice between a 400-seat hall and a 2,200-seat hall. Sure. And we're going to make a place for them. And we've got a calendar and a professional manager that manages that calendar to make sure that the people from Lubbock who need to use a facility, it's going to be available to them. And it's going to be affordable so that they can use it.
Well, that's really great. You know, opening up to the niche for the Broadway series and everything else and growing other opportunities and the newness and being downtown, I think, is really going to add to whatever family events and anything else that could be there, and family support for, you said, dance recitals and things of that nature, which obviously brings us up to the next conversation. It's going to fill a great role that we will not miss by the Auditorium Coliseum going away. And so I think with the Auditorium Coliseum going away and what we promote on May 5th for everybody to vote in favor of Prop A, I think between the United Supermarkets Arena, the Civic Center Auditorium, and now with Buddy Holly Hall, I think there's going to be quite a bit of event opportunity for all the things that went on in the auditorium. And so, and I think in some respect, even the Coliseum. So in that respect, I bet you guys would probably favor the opportunity to suggest to people to vote in favor of the proposition on May 5th as well.
Well, I certainly support the proposition. This opportunity gives the city the flexibility to make the changes that they need to make. Half of the question is answered. I believe Buddy Holly Hall very adequately, exceptionally replaces the auditorium. And for the city then to be able to look at a standalone Coliseum type facility, a dirt floor arena, if you will, they have to have permission to do that. Right. And so that's what's important about this vote. It doesn't mean that it's going to close immediately. Texas Tech has already said that the rodeo is going to be available there through 2019, but they've also said that they don't necessarily have a plan that takes that building down anytime soon. Yeah.
They're going to use it for their basketball practice.
Could extend even further.
And that's what they're using it for now, yeah. The men's and women's basketball team practice in that building. And so that could extend beyond 2019 or 2020 even before they get their new basketball practice facility built. So it's hard to say exactly when it would come down if it's handed over, but I just think it's very, very important that city leadership, county leadership, Texas Tech leadership be given the opportunity to plan for a best case scenario.
And I look at it in the way I've explained it, is that ignites the planning after May 5th for once that we do have a favorable vote where the people have voted and they have said we want to do away with the auditorium or abandon the Auditorium Coliseum. That really ignites the opportunity. There's a lot of talk of some expo dirt floor arena type of planning that are going on. There are several mm-hmm. camps, but I think all in all that will really add a lot of bit of impetus and more interest, and I I really do think that'll be a successful planning opportunity for once May 5th is over.
I think it's very much the impetus. Abandon is an unfortunate choice of words, but that's what's
in the charter.
It's what's in the legislation, and it's the language that they have to use. But it does give the city and other leaders time to determine needs to be done. And those things, you know, you and I together went through a long feasibility study process to understand how and what needed to be done for the Performing Arts Center and what became Buddy Holly Hall. And we need to go through that again. And whether the city is leading that or whether LEPA is leading that or someone else, some other group in the community, it doesn't really matter. You've got to go through that process.
The changes that have occurred, I mean, since then, obviously, more opportunities. I think that study is very valuable to have done. So, well, this is a great deal. We want to personally, again, thank you for what you've done with your leadership and your service in the community, both with LEPA as well as what you've done with the economic development activities at LEDA and for the Convention and Visitors Bureau. You accepted award for Live Love Lubbock today as far as the Association and Women in Communications. It was awfully proud to see you up there to do that. So thank you again, Tim, for what you're doing, and we appreciate the opportunity to have these conversations more in the future as well.
Well, I look forward to it, Eddie. Thank you very much.
Thank you.